Okay. So areas, basically first thing in the areas chapter is you should be able to draw the graphs. Okay. Don't ask the question how to draw the graphs. You already studied coordinate geometry, circles, parabola, ellipse, hyperbola. So we'll be coming across parabola equations quite a bit. In first year calculus, a lot of graphs we have drawn. Okay. So and separately we taught how to draw the graphs. So there's no need to again ask or discuss how to draw the graphs. As we do the questions, again you will be remembered by chance if you forgot. But the most important thing is to draw the graph. Okay, next. We have different cases. The first case which you can see on the screen. You look at this figure. Y equal to f of x. You can see it, it is above x-axis. What is the shape? Doesn't matter, it is above x-axis. You want to find area of y equal to f of x between that and y x-axis, between the lines x equal to a and x equal to b. So this vertical line is x equal to a, this vertical line is x equal to b, this is y equal to f of x, this is x-axis. So you want all this area. Okay, so that is integral a to b y dx, and y means f of x. So integral a to b f of x dx will give you that area. If the curve is completely above x-axis, that's what you do. If it is completely below x-axis, if you take integral a to b f of x dx, you are going to get negative because the curve is below. This is the curve. This is x equal to a, this is x equal to b, this is x-axis. So when you find only the integral a to b f of x dx is going to come negative because all your y is negative. You have to take minus of that. So integral a to b minus y dx or minus integral a to b f of x. One may say, what if it is partly above x-axis and partly below x-axis? Here you can see, between a to c, the curve is above x-axis. And between C to B, the curve is below x-axis. Then, if you directly find integral A to B, you are not going to get the required area. For example, if this area is 80 units, this area is 30 units, our final answer should be 110 units. But if you directly take integral A to B, f of x dx, you are going to get 50. Okay. So you have to write two parts, integral A to C, f of x dx. That will give you this area. Integral c to b f of x dx will not give this area, it will give a negative of this area. So you have to take integral c to b minus f of x dx. So someone which is below, you have to take minus of that. Okay, so there are the three cases that we are seeing. That is, we have one curve. What if you have two curves and we want to find area between them? So y equal to f of x is this curve, y equal to g of x this curve. We want area between them, that too between the two lines, x equal to a and x equal to b. That will be integral a to b upper curve minus lower curve. Upper curve is f of x and lower curve is g of x. So f of x minus g of x. In fact, this you can use always, you can use this. Upper curve minus lower curve will give area between the curves. Even if, let us say, one curve is too much oscillating like this. Another curve is also somewhat oscillating like this. It doesn't matter. You want area between x equal to a and x equal to b. This full area between the two red curves and green curves will be given by integral a to b f of x minus g of x dx. And where is x-axis doesn't even matter. Whether x-axis here, partly above x-axis, partly below x, all that doesn't matter. When they're asking area between two curves, simply you take upper curve minus lower curve in that interval. What if sometimes f is upper and g is lower, and after some time f is lower and g is upper, then what? Okay, so look at this. Okay, So this is f of x. And this is g of x. So up to c, f is greater than g. But after c, g is greater than f. Then what to do? You have to split again. Between a to c, I wrote f minus g because f is higher, g is low. Plus integral c to b, g is higher and f is lower. So you have to take g minus f. So upper curve minus lower. This upper curve minus lower curve can be applicable. You can apply even to the beginning cases. For example, this case, very first case we discussed. You want this area. What is the upper curve? F. What is the lower curve? X-axis. And x-axis equation is y equal to 0. We can write f of x minus 0. That is f of x. And if you take this case, here x-axis is the upper curve and f of x is the lower curve. So if you want this area, upper curve minus lower curve, it is 0 minus f of x. That's why minus f of x is coming. Upper curve is 0, lower curve is f of x. So I think you don't have to remember so many things. Simply remember, whenever you want an area, that area is bounded by some line x equal to a on the left side, some line x equal to b on the right side. And there's an upper curve and there's a lower curve. Simply take upper curve minus lower curve. All this discussion is over there. But sometimes you have to do something else. Let us say I have a curve like this. And with respect to y-axis, I want this area. Now I cannot say upper curve, lower curve because the curve is like this and it is not even a function because for one x value there are many y values. Here we will not do integral a to b f of x dx. We will be doing f of y dy. Okay. Where we will be doing the curve with respect to y axis. So if you see here, the curve is there like this. Y equal to c is a horizontal line. Y equal to d is another horizontal line. We want between them up to y axis. So here the limits of y are mentioned. So integral c to d. Instead of taking a y dx, which we were taking earlier, we will take x dy or f of y dy. X you have to express as a function of y, f of y dy. We'll discuss a little more about it. Let us do some questions, get a feel of these functions, and then we'll do. In the beginning, most of the questions that we have will be upper curve minus lower curve or things like that. Okay. So let us do. So take your material. What is this volume 2, right? Take a volume 2. Yes. Yeah, it is page number 191 in volume 2. So if you have the book, please take it out. Okay, we'll do odd numbers as usual, the class. Okay, very first question. Y equal to 3x square by 4. And there is a line 3x minus 2y plus 12 equal to 0. They want area of the region included between this parabola and this line. Okay. So we have to draw the graph. That is one important thing of this and this. Another thing is finding the points of intersection of these two. So let me try to solve these two. 3x minus 2 into, in the place of y, I can write 3x square by 4 plus 12 equal to 0. I can cancel with 1, 2, multiply with the 2 and divide with 3. X minus, cancel 3 and then multiply with 2, so you'll get a 2x here. Here 2 multiplied, 3 removed, so simply x square. Here 3 removed, so it will become 4 and 8. Okay. I'm getting x square minus 2x minus 8 equal to 0. That is x minus 4 into x plus 2 equal to 0. So x is equal to minus 2 or 4. All right. X equal to minus 2 or 4. Now, we all know what is this simple figure. Y equal to x square will be like this. A multiple of x square, as long as a positive number, also somewhat like that one. This is a simple straight line. What are the x-intercept? What are the y-intercept? If I know, I can easily draw. X-intercept means put y equal to 0. X-intercept will be minus 4, somewhere here. Y-intercept, put x equal to 0, it will be 6. So like this, it is somewhat a line like this. This point and this point are minus 2, comma some y-coordinate. I don't have to find it. If I want, I can find it. This is 4 comma something. So if you look at, see, we are drawing x-axis and y-axis just for reference, but actually there are only two curves. I have the parabola and I have the line, that's it. Now, where is the area bounded by these two, the parabola and the line? It is here. So whenever you want to find any area, just identify that area is bounded by some upper curve, some lower curve. This upper curve is a line, but I have to write y equal to f of x form. So I have to write this as y is equal to 3x plus 12 by 2. What is this lower one? Parabola, which is y equal to 3x square by 4. And what is the x coordinate here? What is the x coordinate here? X coordinate here is minus 2, where x coordinate is 4. So between minus 2 and 4, upper curve minus lower curve. So this is a parabola, this is a line, this is minus 2 and this is 4. This is more clarity. So we have to simply take integral minus 2 to 4, upper curve minus lower curve. So upper curve is 3x plus 12 by 2. We have to write y in terms of x. Minus what is y in terms of x for lower curve? 3x square by, this is like f of x minus g of x. Yes. That's it. We have to just integrate. Integral minus 2 to 4. I can simplify if you want as, I'll just leave it as it is. 3x by 2, integral is 3x square by 4. 12 by 2 is 6, integral is 6x. 3x square integral is x. With limits minus 2 to 4. Substitute and simplify whatever comes. When I put 4, this is 3 fourths are 12. This is 24. This is 16. When I put minus 2, this is 3. This is minus 12. This is finally plus 8 by 4, so plus 2. Minus 4 will go, 20 will come. This is 5 minus 12, minus 7 plus 27. As you do questions, it will be clear. Areas is a very easy chapter, not at all difficult. Main part is drawing the figure, understanding the points of intersection, and recognizing which is upper curve, which is the lower curve, with what are the limits. Anybody any doubt regarding this first question? Are you physics and chemistry syllabus are mostly at the end, or a lot of things are there? Can somebody respond?
The maths is only attend sir 1B, definitely.
Maths 2B.
Chemistry is lot of the.
Lot of it is there, and the physics. Physics, which chapter are you in now?
Electromagnetic alternating current, sir.
AC current. Okay. So in physics, you are left with wave optics is covered for you. Thanks, double slit experiment and all. No, right?
Not covered.
Okay. So YDS is left. Communication systems will be left. That modern physics like semiconductors, p-n junction and all. Okay, third question. X minus y plus 2 equal to 0. X equal to root 1. They want area bounded by these two. Okay. One thing I wanted to notice, x equal to root 5, when you square it, you will get x square equal to y. But the graph of this and this are not same. Y equal to x square, it will be like this. Here, y coordinate is anyway positive because this is positive. LHS is positive, so RHS should be positive. Here, x can be negative or positive. Anything is okay. So both will. But coming to this, even though these two are same, there is a slight difference. Y is anyway positive, otherwise root y will not be defined. Root of something, we always take positive only, we don't take negative. So x coordinate must be positive only. So it is this piece will not be there, only it is the right piece. So x equal to root y is only this part. This will not be there. Okay, that is the difference between these two. Then one may ask, what will be the graph of only this piece? That will be minus x equal to root 1. One may say root of something is positive. This is negative. How can they be equal? No, this is not positive. This is not negative. X will be negative and minus x will be positive. That is this quadrant. Right? Okay. So y equal to x square is this. In that root y equal to x graph is only that right part. And root y equal to minus x will be the only the left. Okay. So now I have to take this. What is this figure? X minus y plus 2 equal to 0. This is x equal to root 1. Or you can write y equal to x square. What is this x intercept? When you put y equal to 0, x intercept is minus 2 and y intercept is plus 2. Okay, it is some kind of line like this. It will be some kind of line like this with slope 1 passing through minus 2 comma 0 and 0 comma 2. If you want to know where they are intersecting, we have to solve. Okay, so this is x equal to root y or y equal to x square. If you want to solve, let us substitute this here. X minus x square plus 2 equal to 0. That is x square minus x minus 2 equal to 0. Who is the top? Okay. So here I'll get x equal to 2 or x equal to minus 1. I cannot take minus 1, I can take 2. Because the point of intersection is here. Actually, if you take the neglected part, we'll also get minus 1 there. Okay. Now we want this area. This point is 2, comma, when x is 2, y is 4. Now, we have to integrate from 0 to 2. What is the question anyway? The area bounded by the curve and y-axis also mentioned in the question. So they mentioned three things in the question. Let me draw that figure. We have drawn x and y-axis only for reference, but in the question they mentioned only three things. The curve, this line, and y-axis. That's all. These are the three things mentioned. So what is the area bounded by all the three? The curve, this line, and y-axis. This is. For that region, the upper curve is the line, and the line we should write y equal to x plus. And lower curve is this y equal to x square parabola. Between 0 to 2 we want. So the required area is integral 0 to 2. Upper curve is x plus 2. Lower curve is x square. Yes. X integral is x square by 2. 2 integral is 2x minus x cube by 3 with 0 to 2. 0 anyway, if you put 2, it will be 2 plus 4 minus 8 by 3. 6, 6, 3 is 18, so finally 10 by 3. Okay. So mainly drawing the graphs, understanding which region they want, and then seeing from what x value to integrate in that region, what is the upper curve, what is the lower curve, where y is in terms of x. This question or previous question, if anybody any doubt, please ask. Otherwise, just copy. I said x equal to root y, if you square it, you'll get y equal to x square, that is this. But x equal to root y is only this part, that is the right part, not the left part, because x coordinate can't be negative. Okay, so I drawn the curve, I drawn the line, I want this region. So that region, and when I found the point of intersection by solving these two, I got x equal to 2. So I have to integrate from 0 to 2, upper curve is x plus 2, lower function is x square, upper curve minus lower curve. Is it all right, Dhanush? There is a good chance that your exams will be in March only, IP theory exams. That's what government sent a notification. What is the syllabus and all? Maybe they had to finalize, but they said by March end only they wanted to keep your exams theory. I don't know about practicals and all details. NTA not yet released any dates about your mains exam. And it comes with them. I think regarding physical classes, when it will start, I think from college, you are getting calls, your parents, they must be talking to your parents and taking the opinion. After that, I think based on the majority, they'll come to some conclusion, whether to keep or when to keep. But many parents are quite afraid of the second wave of corona, where people are dying much faster rate, maybe, possibly. So many parents did not agree. They said at least wait for one more month before you start physical classes. Okay, anybody still any doubt regarding third question? Okay, fifth question. Y square equal to 4x. We all know the standard parabola equation. And a lattice rectum, I think all of you know, lattice rectum is the passing through focus a comma 0. This is a comma 2a. This is a comma minus 2. So parabola is there, lattice rectum is there. There is an area bounded by these two. They want that between the parabola and its own lattice rectum. By chance, if somebody missed about parabola chapter, just don't worry so much. Y is equal to 4x figure is this. X equal to a line is this. This is called lattice rectum. They want that area. They want this total area. I can do upper curve minus lower curve, or I can say by symmetry, this region and this region areas are equal. Instead of finding the total, I'll find only upper part and double it. Okay, anybody want to tell only this upper one, what are the equation, and only this lower one, what are the equation? The parabola, upper piece has one equation, lower piece has one equation. Anybody want to tell what are they? This upper part equation is y equal to root 4x. This lower part is y equal to minus root 4x. Okay, because y square equal to 4x means y equal to, you'll get plus or minus root 4x. Plus root 4x for the upper one because y coordinate is positive. Minus because RHS is negative, LHS will be negative, that is for the lower part. So, if somebody wants to find area, they have to find between 0 to a. This is upper curve, this is a lower curve. So they can write area equal to integral 0 to a root 4ax minus root 4ax. Upper curve minus lower curve. Or I said already, don't find the lower part by symmetry, just find the upper part, double it. That is same as 2 times 0 to a root 4ax. You can see both are same. Minus of minus will be plus. Root 4ax plus root 4ax will be 2 times root 4ax. Instead of that, directly you can say this. What is that? Upper curve and lower curve is x-axis. X-axis means y equal to 0. You don't have to subtract me. Okay. So 0 to a root 4ax dx will give this area double of that. Okay. So 2 into root 4a, I can separate it. Root x means x power 1 by 2. And x power 1 by 2 integral is x power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2. From 0 to 2 into root 4a into, when you put a, you will get a power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2. This 3 by 2 will become 4 by 3. This is 2 root a. This is a root a. A power 3 by 2 is a into a power 1 by 2. So finally, it is 8a square by 3. Anybody, any doubt, any part of it, please ask. Mm-hmm. Please put on your videos, everyone. Samuel, are you able to follow?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Suhas Villuri, you're able to follow?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, before I forget, past year mains questions in the first year end, just before IP exams of first year were done for some people, where I gave a book where questions are there with a gap also there to write solutions. I want those solutions PDF, so those people who are there at that time, I'll be sending some messages to in the afternoon. Please use CAM scanner or paper scanner, some kind of app, and I want those solutions PDF, okay? I'll be sending which chapter you should send. I remember some names of the people who are there last year. Swati is there, Roshni, Avinash, and Chandrasai Teja, Bharat, these people are there. Maybe some more. Teja Satna, you're also there, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you completed the at least what we had done at that time in the class, we completed all of them, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Dhanesh, you are also there, okay. Whoever is there at that time, just send a message to me so that I will know, okay, later on after class is over. Whoever was there at that time, some 20, 25 days, we run some program so that I can assign some chapters for you to send. All right, fifth one. Anybody any doubt regarding this fifth one? Okay, seventh question, the area lying in the first and 2y minus x plus 3 equal to 0. Okay. Again, when you square it, it is y square equal to x. Like a parabola, y square equal to 4ax. So y square equal to 4ax, where a is positive, you know the parabola is like this. Within that, y equal to root 4ax, I said only the upper one. And y equal to minus root 4ax, I said only the term. Like that here, y equal to root x is like this, it is only the upper part. Not the down part. And coming to this line, when x intercept means put y equal to 0, x intercept is 3. and y intercept means x equal to 0, y intercept is minus 3 by 2. Okay, so I'm sure it is like this. This is 0 comma minus 3 by 2, this point. What is this point? How to solve? Wherever y is there, I can write root x and solve. It will be 2 root x minus x plus 3 equal to 0. X minus 2 root x minus 3 equal to 0. This x actually I can write root x whole square. Root x whole square minus 2 root x minus 3. It's like a quadratic equation. With the root x minus 3 into root x plus 1 equal to 0. So root x equal to 3 or minus 1. Can't be minus 1, so root x must be 3. So this point will be 3 comma root. Is it correct? Something wrong? No. Like root x is 3 means x is 9. It will be 9 comma. Okay, now what they want? Area lying in the first quadrant bounded by the curves this and x-axis. So x-axis, this curve, this, so if they want this area. Here there is a slight problem with the upper curve minus lower curve. Why? If you take this full shaded region and what is this point x-intercept of this? That is, we put y equal to 0. This is some 3 comma 0. Up to 3, upper curve is the parabola, lower curve is x-axis. After 3, upper curve is parabola and lower curve is the line. So I cannot directly, okay, so I don't want this area because in the clearly mentioned in the question, the area lying in the first quadrant bounded by this curve and x-axis. So there are two ways to do this. If I do upper curve minus lower curve, I have to break at 3. Or I can do right curve minus left curve. I was talking about areas like this, right? Okay, so sometimes you can have curves like this and you want this area. You can take right curve minus left curve with limits y equal to something to y equal to something. Earlier, when we have curves like this, we are taking from A to B. X is changing from A to B. Y equal to f of x minus y equal to g of x, upper curve minus lower curve. Here you have to write x in terms of y here, x in terms of y. And then take limits of y. So I'll tell you both methods. So method one, what is y value here? Y equal to 0. What is y value here? Y equal to 3. What is this as x in terms of y? This line is x equal to 2y plus 3. What is this x in terms of y? X equal to y square. So it is 0 to 3. Y equal to 0 to y equal to 3. Right curve is 2y plus 3. I have to write x in terms of y. Minus left curve, x in terms of y is y square. So that's it. 2y integral is y square plus 3y minus y cubed by 3. Put 0 to 3. When I put 3, it will be 9 plus 9 minus 9. When I put 0, everything is 0. So directly answer is 9. If still want to do upper curve minus lower curve, I have to write integral 0 to 3. Up to 3, the upper curve is y equal to root x. And lower curve is x-axis. That's why I'm writing 0. But from 3 to 9, upper curve is parabola, lower curve is the line. Parabola is root x minus the line is, I have to write y in terms of x, so I have to write x minus 3 by 2. Actually, it's an objective question, so you can even do something else. What is that? Don't worry about this line. You can find this full area by integration. And you can find this area by simple triangle off into base into height. You can also do that. Maybe I can do that first. Method 3. This total, this piece area is, this is 0 and this is 9. So integral 0 to 9, and what is the parabola root x dx? Minus, I have to remove this triangle where base is 6 and height is 3. This is 6 unit, this is 3. Half into 6 into 3. Root x integral is x power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 from 0 to 9. This is 9. So this is 2 by 3. 9 power 3 by 2 means 9 into 3 minus 9. 3, 3 will cancel. 18 minus 9. So x is 9. Or you have to write between 0 to 3, upper minus lower, upper curve is root x, parabola, lower curve is x-axis. Integral 3 to 9, upper curve is a parabola and lower curve is a line. Simplify this integration, answer should come. So root x is x power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2. So 2 by 3, x power 3 by 2 with 0 to 3. They are also same. 2 by 3 x power 3 by 2 minus x by 2 integral is x square by 4 plus 3x by 2 from 3 to 9. Okay, I'm not going to simplify.
Yes, method 1.
Method 1 is when I have some curve like this and some curve like this and I want an area between y equal to c and y equal to d. Write this curve as some x equal to f of y. This curve as x equal to some g of y. Integral c to d, right curve minus left curve. We will get integral c to d, f of y minus g of y dy. Okay. Basically, what happens is when you studied about what is definite integration, we took lot of elements like this, lot of rectangles like this, we added areas. Instead of that, if somebody wants this area, you can add lot of rectangles like this and then add. That is exactly what we are doing this. That's why. Well, that is the difference between y dx and x dy. Y dx means your curve is like this. If you take a strip, each width is dx and height is y. That's why. And what is the area of this rectangle? Y dx. Integration is after all summation. In fact, it is like S na. Integration symbol is actually summation. It is like a continuous summation basically. Y dx means you are taking strips like this. X dy means you are taking strips, curves like this. You are saying this is x and the width is dy. Y is changing. Anyway. So, you take some y value to y value, right curve minus left curve, where right curve you have to write x as a function of y, left curve also you have to write x as a function of y. So coming to here, this is my region. What is the right curve? This line. What is the left curve? This line. So right curve minus left curve. What is this right curve when you write x as one terms of y? 2y plus. What is left curve when you write x in terms of y? Y square. And what is your y value here? 0. Your y value here. Is it okay now?
Yes.
So any method 1 or method 2 or method 3, anything you have doubt, please ask. Here we found point of intersection. Here we have drawn the figure. This is right curve minus left curve, limits of y. This is upper curve minus lower curve, but two pieces. This is directly find this area by one simple straight integral minus this triangle directly off into base into height. Method 2, between 0 to 3, upper curve is parabola, lower curve is x-axis. So root x is parabola, 0 is this. Between 3 to 9, the upper curve is parabola, lower curve is line. Parabola minus line, that is this region. So one will give you this area, plus other will give you this area. That is this plus this. Is it okay, Danush? Okay. Was it completed? Can try 9th question. I just want to take time to understand, but please do write all the three methods so that you'll get a better clarity. Okay, 9th question. I'll tell 9th question how to do it, but I want to tell something else. In any curve, if you interchange x and y, what will happen? Wherever x is there, you write y. Wherever y is there, you write x. What will happen?
As I made with respect to x is equal to y.
Yeah, you'll get mirror image with respect to y equal to x line, or you can say for the original function, you'll get inverse function. The thing is, let us say I wanted some area somehow. Let us say I found a mirror image of this whole figure here, somewhat like this. This area and this area will be same because in mirror image, area will not change. The size of the things will not change, right? So this coming to this question, as it is question, how to do, I'll tell you. Or let us interchange x and y in the whole question. Instead of x equal to y square, I'll write y equal to x square. Instead of x is equal to 3 minus 2y square, I'll write y equal to 3 minus 2x square. If I find area between these two, that is same as area between the given two curves. Now, these are, what is this y equal to x square figure? Y equal to x square will be like this. How are you going to draw y equal to 3 minus 2x square? Is that x square will be like this, or 2x square will be like this? Minus 2x square will be downward. And then add 3 minutes, it will go up. So it will be like this. So y equal to 3 minus 2x square graph like this. One way to understand is, 2x square is upward, minus 2x square downward, move 3 units up. Another way to understand is, bring 2x square here, 3 that side, you'll get 2x square equal to minus of y minus 3. Bring this 2 down, you'll get x minus 0 whole square equal to minus 1 by 2 into y minus 3. In parabola chapter, x minus h whole square equal to 4a into y minus k. It is a vertical parabola with vertex h comma k. And if 4a is positive upward parabola, 4a is negative downward parabola. What is that vertex? 0 comma 3. So this vertex is 0 comma 3. Instead of upward, it is downward parabola. So you can understand that way. So by parabola chapter, you can understand. Or I said take 2x square, reverse it, minus 2x square, move upward 3 units. Anyway, you can understand this graph, whichever way you want. Now let us try to find point of intersection. Anyway, we want this area. We have one parabola like this, one parabola, the area bounded between them. So I need to find the points of intersection and do upper curve minus lower curve. Let us solve. X square equal to 3 minus 2 x square. 3 x square equal to 3. X square equal to 1. X equal to plus or minus 1. When I put x equal to 1, this point is 1 comma 1. This point is minus 1 comma 1. So here x coordinate is minus 1. Here x coordinate is 1. Upper curve minus lower curve. Upper curve is y equal to 3 minus 2 x square. And lower curve is y equal to x square. So integral minus 1 to 1, 3 minus 2x square, upper curve, minus lower curve is x square. This is the required area. So integral minus 1 to 1, 3 minus 3x square, 3x minus x cube from minus 1 to 1. So when I put 1, it is 3 minus 1, next one I put minus 1, minus 3 plus 1, 2 plus 2, 4. Anybody any doubt in this question?
Sir, instead of interchanging, if we do directly also, we'll get the answers.
We'll do it. I drawn this because some people may find this equations are easy to find the curves. Samuel, you have started revising circles or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. It's a revision class. Are you able to follow to some extent?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In normal classes, I'll tell more detail with a lot of examples. There, I was only telling theory. Anushri, are you there when I told circles? You're also not there. Okay. Are you seeing those videos? You are able to follow?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay, let us say same thing with the as it is given equations, what will happen? X equal to y square and x equal to 3 minus 2y square. Okay, y equal to x square will be like this. This is like y square equal to 4ax, so it is like this. This is, if you want, you can write y square equal to minus of x minus 3 by 2. The parabola opening towards left with vertex 3 comma 0. It will be like this. This is 3 comma 0. Okay. And both we have to express x in terms of y now. So this is x equal to 3 minus 2y square. This is x equal to y square, and you try to solve and find y coordinates. Y square equal to 3 minus 2y square, 3y square equal to 3, y square equal to 1, y equal to plus or minus 1. This point will be 1 comma minus 1, this point will be 1 comma 1. So here I have to do what? Y coordinate from minus 1 to 1, right curve minus left curve, where you have to write x in terms of y. So you are going to get integral minus 1 to 1. The right curve is 3 minus 2y square minus the left curve is y square. And we wanted this. Of course, it is even function. So minus 1 to 1, I can write 2 times 0 to 1 also. Not so important. 3 minus 3y square d. 3y minus y cube with limits 0 to 1. And I put 1, it is 3 minus 1, 2 to search. Same, you will not even get anything. Integration also will be same. Only thing is that wherever y is there, x will come. That's all. There are not a big difference. So those who are there for parabola beginning classes, at least you'll be able to understand the graphs more easily, especially of the parabolas. Even without that also, we'll be able to draw these graphs.